solemn, and the other one stay where they are. Okay. 10 to the 17, we got 10 penalty. That in the length of the repeated cycle, then you take 1 over this number here. So the length of the cycle, the number of digits in the cycle that you have to go with roughly 50. So more than 1,000, million, billion, trillion, this is quadrillions. Okay, how far the cycle extends before it repeats. And that means that when you take quotient of z by this n, that value that you have, let's say that it starts like this, 5,5,2,0,2,9,8,5,1,9,0. And then it carries on for about 300 quadrillion digits before it repeats again. So to specify that quotient, to write it out, to know exactly what it is, requires a huge amount of data. Okay, because there's this number of digits in this dummy before it starts to repeat. You can see that this is already overwhelming our hard drives, the way we can deal with this, in terms of storing all this stuff. And you can see that it's gotten a lot more complicated than it did when we just had 3 bars. And you can imagine that if we added a few more bars, or maybe 100 more bars, or maybe a million more bars, this is going to blow up ours completely. Completely blow up ours. That means those people that are before me completely understand what this quotient is. Okay, so then the difficulties with factoring huge numbers like this are at least two goals that we've seen. First of all, there's the obvious problem of finding prime that divides if the number is okay. It's very onerous finding a prime that actually divides. But even once we have some primes that divide it, we're seeing that the quotient that we get, dividing the number by the primes that we have so far found and getting a smaller quotient, it's not the case that the problem is getting simpler. Because although these quotients are in fact getting smaller, they are getting more complicated. They are more complex. The complexity is getting bigger. So the complexity is increasing even as these quotients become smaller. That's exactly what we've been demonstrating with this division process that we've been looking at here, right? The complexity of the quotients goes up. And this is something that's not seen at the level of medium ordinary level factorization. You've got a number of 300 digits and you're trying to factorize it and try that prime, and if you divide one way, now your new quotient is a little bit smaller. The 300 digits, maybe it's 249 digits. But every prime that you find, you're happy because the quotient is getting smaller. Here, yes, the quotient is getting smaller, but that's not the crucial point. The point is that the complexity is going up. And it's not going up just, in a small way. It's going up pretty good. We saw that there's a huge difference between just taking the first 3 primes and taking those 6 or 7 primes. Oh, yeah, that's complexity. Less than having a cycle of 138, we had a cycle of 300 quadrillion. Huge difference. So, what actually happens is that the complexity just overwhelms you because you can build out the numbers. At some point, this number is going to be so big that you can't write it down with all numbers. You are at sea. So the reality is that it really is impossible to fully factorize that problem. I'm not sure. The complexity of this problem overwhelms the possible complexity inherent in our universe. Okay, we're causing a mathematical problem whose complexity dwarfs the ability of the universe to encode a solution. That's just what it is. Okay, this is just the reality of the world. It has nothing to do with our computers exactly what they appear to, but it's really a problem about the world ultimately, about the problems for fact about the world. Okay, right now, we think of the numbers, in fact, we see that there's lots of difference within writing to a lot bigger numbers than that. So what I'm saying now about that applies even more so for all those other gigantic numbers that we've been exploring in some of our previous videos. So what you could wrong? You could clearly state that every number has a unique factorization front, and now I hope I can get to you that the number Z does not have such a unique factorization, so there's a problem somewhere, and perhaps you could go wrong. But I find that no, he's not. In fact, the problem is really with modern times. It's we that have a problem, not you. That's a very important point, an interesting point that I want to share with you. We have to go back a little bit and recognize that ancient Greeks had a different approach to numbers than we do, very different approach, because they were solidly grounded in a geometrical understanding of things. Mathematics to them was primarily geometrical. The number theory was built upon the geometry. So if you look 5 to 10 of the elements, he deals with magnitude and relation between them. But the human magnitudes are typically things associated with measurements, involving, say, length, or area, or volume. So to him, a number was really more a measurement of something rather than a counting of something. Which is not to say that the aspect didn't play a role, it certainly did. In fact, it has a lot to do with this idea of proportion, that if we have a segment like this or a segment like this, then we can talk about the proportion between them, or we can say the proportion of their length. But in fact, you just thought geometrically that you could divide this the opposite way. Ratio. It's not because it wasn't really counting forces, because it wasn't even a measure of forces exactly. Not if you got a ruler to measure that. It was more a finding of a commensurability finding of that force. Objects could be subdivided into very different kind of approach to numbers, and that really explains why I was not wrong about his statement about unique factorization. So far, he makes that definition that demonstrates or shows the kind of idea he had about the relative size of the numbers. He says that magnitude represents how the ratios of one another, which are seen as the multiplier of exceeding one another, which is the translation of the. So,
Thank you.